Hi everybody, welcome to Crandall Reviews. Today I'm taking a look at the Star Wars Steelbooks that just came out. Now I famously went on a rant about how I wasn't going to buy these because the artwork was idiotic for each title. It didn't really make sense outside of a couple. And while I still believe that to be true, they did reveal that the back artwork was going to be the original posters that we all know and love. So I caved and had to get them. Now, they are quite gorgeous steelbooks. So if we take a look here, this is the Episode 1 steelbook with Darth Maul on the cover. Now, this one makes perfect sense. High gloss. Every case has Star Wars debossed, the logo right there, which is really nice looking. Then, of course, the back is that original poster artwork that I mentioned that just looks gorgeous. Now, if they had done these as the front, it would be complete no-brainers. But Fox putting these out with the same discs that they originally issued, no new special features, no changes, no nothing. All the discs are just the same as they were before. But the steelbooks are available for pretty cheap, like $15 each. And so for that, I thought it was worth it just because high gloss, the debossing, and the great artwork. So Phantom Menace, that is the interior art of the Jedi Council talking to little Annie. Probably not going to watch this one much, but this is a badass looking case. As underused as Darth Maul was, this is a great looking steelbook. Yoda on Attack of the Clones. Again, this one sort of makes sense for the movie, although why we only get Yoda as the only hero in the series doesn't make sense, but gorgeous deboxing. I love the green. Then we've got the classic poster art for Episode 2 right there. Looks really nice. On the inside, we've got all of the army of clones assembling. Who is Sifo Dyas? Not that that matters right now. So another one that just, these are high gloss, really nice steel books. They're a little bit thin on the metal side. They're easily dented. Then we've got General Grievous on Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. Now they've really changed the color timing of the original poster for Sith, but the artwork still looks nice. Although I really like the sort of orange and red hues that the original poster had because it reminds us of Mustafar, which we see on the inside, the battle between Anakin and Obi-Wan, which is some nice interior art because that is such a key pivotal moment of the Star Wars saga in the prequels. Moving on to the great ones, the original trilogy, A New Hope gets Darth Vader, which is completely badass. This looks great. Again, that debossing is just so nice. Original poster artwork on the back, which is fantastic. I really do like that they left the episode numbers off of these cases. It might bug some completists, but for me, it just, if you want to pick and choose and pretend that the prequels don't exist, these don't have numbers on the cases, so it can help you do that even better. On the inside, great shot of Luke on Tatooine. Moving on to everyone's favorite, the best in the series, Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back, which gets the worst cover in a Stormtrooper. Now, it's a nice picture of a Stormtrooper, but if we're going to go obscure for Empire Strikes Back, let's put Boba Fett on there. Even if we had, like, an AT-AT on the cover, or Lando, it would be better. Then again, we've got the classic original artwork that just looks so nice on these steelbooks. They tinted it a little bit yellow to sort of match with the color scheme that they're going for here, but it just looks really nice. I love this movie so much. And then on the interior, we do get those AT-AT walkers, which is awesome. The Hoth battle sequence, one of the best in the entire franchise. Then rounding out this series with Return of the Jedi, Emperor Palpatine on the cover, and that great classic Jedi artwork on the back. Again, if the backs were the fronts, these would be must-own for everyone. I'm a big Star Wars nerd, so even despite that rant, I had to get them. And I am glad I did, because this artwork here is just super nice. And then on the inside, we've got the big battle at the end. Really good quality. So even though I was initially hesitant because the artworks didn't seem to make much sense, the actual finished product that Fox has delivered is a good-looking, nice steelbook, even if the discs are the exact same discs you already own, $15 a piece. If you're a big-time steelbook collector like me, you're going to want to get it. If not, maybe wait until they go down in price, although they are claimed to be limited edition, so we'll have to wait and see how limited that edition ends up being. Thanks a lot for watching, and don't forget to hit subscribe.